So hi guys, welcome back to Entirety YouTube channel. I'm your host Yashraj Jaiswal, and today you learn how you can scrape the charting screener and get the trades into your Telegram. So let's start by just opening the terminal and open the Jupyter notebook. Now let's just create a new Python notebook. Start by importing the pandas library. Import a Selenium library. Selenium is basically the main that we will use for getting the stocks, okay, out of that charting screener. So there's one another library in the name of schedule. So yeah, let's just run these. Now let's open the charting.com and fetch the link for the screener we want, okay. Suppose we want out of all these screeners, we want suppose high volume stocks, okay. So we are making an alert system such that as soon as the market opens, okay, it will basically scan, okay, or basically get the scanned stocks at 9:30 a.m. okay, for the first time, and then at an interval of every 15 minutes, it will basically get the stocks which were not there, okay, in the previous basically the screened stocks, okay. So which were not screened earlier, it will basically send those, okay, now this time. So let's start by doing that. So we have the high volume stocks screener. So we'll just copy the link, okay. Now URL is the basically this portion, and so first of all let's just import the web driver, okay. So from Selenium import web driver, okay. So web driver dot chrome of executable path, so it basically requires the Chrome driver, okay. So I have the Chrome driver at my desktop location. So let's just copy the location. And what is it? Chrome driver. Okay. So we have got the Chrome web driver. Okay. So as you can now see that as soon as we hit this command or web driver dot Chrome, it basically opened a Chrome web driver window, okay, wherein we can basically use it to do our various automations, okay. So for now let's just assign a variable to it to do further manipulations, okay. So since now we have just assigned the variable driver to it, we can now open the URL, okay. So just get. So as you can now see, as soon as we hit this driver dot get URL, it opened that volume screener in this Chrome window, okay, in this driver window. Now our basically the priority is to scan for this basically table, okay. So to fetch this table, what we can do is simply let's just inspect, okay, inspect this whole thing and inspect this this part. Since now we have this table element, okay, we can just go and copy the XPath, okay. As soon as we hit the copy XPath, it will basically copy this basically XPath, okay. So what is this? This is basically an identity assigned to this table, okay. In future this identity may change and we need to be adaptive as per the changes, okay. So in future if this changes, we have to change this in our code as well, okay. And there is more than this XPath way, and there is one we can use the class, okay, class or the ID or whatever. There are more than this way, okay. We can use those to make it somewhat stable, or that may also change, okay. So first of all get the driver dot find element by id, or basically the XPath we are having here, okay, dot get attribute outer HTML. Okay, so let's just run this. Okay, so from that we have got the basically the screened table. Okay, so if we just look at this carefully, so what we can find is, see, the South Bank is found here. Okay, so the something limited is showing here, South Indian Bank itself. Okay, so this is BHEL, BHEL. So we have got the basically the HTML. Okay, so what we can do is there is a function in the name of HTML in the library pandas. Okay, so we can basically read the HTML out of this. Okay, so yeah, as you can see, we have just got the table what is looking similar here. Okay, so Himachal Futuristic Communications Limited. Okay, so same, and all these 10 stocks. Okay, so as we can check the basically the serial number, and this is the 10. Okay, so now let's assign a table variable to it. Okay, and let's check the table. Okay, so basically the zeros. Okay, so we now have the screened stocks list. Okay, so our next goal is to basically arrange it in a format such that we can use or get something out of this. Okay, so what we can do is we can just simply create a function out of this. Okay, so wherein whenever we hit this function, or whenever we call this function, so we'll get this. Okay, so whenever we call this function, we will basically get these screened stocks. Okay, so definition of get screened stocks, and here we can hit the URL. Okay, so we can send the URL inside this, and we can return this table part. Okay, so if we just call this get screened stocks, it will automatically. Okay, so one thing we missed. Okay, so what we can do is we can simply close this Chrome window as soon as our work is over. So we can do is driver.close this one. Okay, so as soon as we hit that, the driver automatically closed. Okay, one more driver is open, so I'll try closing that as well. Okay, so that is not linked to this driver. Okay, so let's just close it manually, and yeah, now we'll simply copy this into this part. Okay, yeah, so let's just run this once again and get a screen stocks. Okay, one URL is missing. Okay, yeah, okay, so as you can now see, we just hit that screen stocks URL, basically the function, we just use that, and we are now getting the whole table of the screen stocks. Okay, so what we can now do is we can basically get this to our Telegram. Okay, so for getting this to our Telegram, what we have to do is we have to import a Telegram library. There is a library in the name of Telegram. Okay, so let me show you Telegram. So this is the library meant for Telegram. Okay, so we can just simply install this, okay, using our terminal or the Jupyter notebook. Okay, so let's just install this. Okay, now what we can do is simply import Telegram. So since now we have called the Telegram library, okay, we need to have a connection established with the Telegram. Okay, so let's just open the Telegram first. As you can now see, we have opened the Telegram. We need to create a bot first of all. Okay, there is a bot in the name of Bot Father. Okay, if you search for bot father, if bot father, you will get this bot father. Okay, with a blue tick. Remember, blue tick. Okay, so just start by clicking the start button. Okay, it will now show you a list of multiple commands. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to basically have a bot or basically a person who can just convey our message to the group or channel or whatever we want. Okay, so just have a new bot. Okay, so how are we going to call it? Please choose a name for the bot. So we can choose a name as charting bot, charting screener bot. Now let's choose a username for the bot. So I'm choosing the username as chart ink screen bot. Okay, charting screener bot. Okay, so as you can now see, use this token to access the HTTP API. Okay, so we have got the API to basically establish a connection between the Python notebook and the this basically bot. Okay, so this is our bot token. Okay, bot token. Okay, so for now, since we have the bot token, we have to send this basically these all these stocks somewhere. Okay, so that may be our own ID or channel or a group. Okay, so let's just now create a group. Now just add basically a member to the group. Okay, just add this my identity. Okay, so let's just select a photo. Okay, now give a name, charting group. Okay, now since we have already created this charting screener bot, okay, we can now add the bot to the group. Okay, so we can add the charting screener bot to the group. Okay, so okay, so to basically have the access as a bot to send the messages or edit the messages to the group, okay, or from the group, we need to add the bot as an admin. Okay, so let's just grant the bot an admin basically position. Okay, so as you now can see that charting screener bot is the admin. Okay, so let's just also give this charting group a basically a username. Okay, so let's just give this group type is public and the username is charting group. Okay, charting group. Yeah, so let's just copy the address. Okay, or basically the this is the location. Okay, so the channel ID CHANNEL or basically the group ID. Okay, so now we have to just to message basically this bot, message using this bot to the group. Okay, so there is, let's just first create an instance. Okay, so telegram dot bot and the token is to bot token. Okay, and yeah, that's it. So let's just create a instance. Okay, bot dot we can do is send message. Okay, send text or message, send message to the chat ID equal to group ID and the group ID, this chatting group, okay? And what is the text we are trying to send? Okay, so text hello world. Okay, so as you now can see, we have just received a message from the chatting screener bot. Okay, hello world. Okay, we have now received an address. Okay, so we can simply save this to basically message ID. Okay, so as we now can see, another message is sent. Okay, now we can delete the message ID. Message ID dot, we can delete the message we just sent. Okay, so message ID dot delete. Okay, of just, yeah, so this will basically delete the message we just sent. Okay, and now let's just basically merge this. So now let's check. So let's just send another message. Okay, instead of hello world, we can say chatting haha. Okay, so chatting haha is sent. And if we just since we now have the message id, let me show you message id. Okay, this is the message id. Okay, so we can delete the message, okay, by message id. Okay, so it is showing true. Okay, message is also deleted. Now the next step would be the to sending basically reply. Okay, suppose we have sent this message chatting haha. Okay, so we can basically reply via text. Okay, so message id dot reply reply underscore text text, yeah. So what we can do is say ha 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 ha. Okay, so yeah, just have a look. Okay, ha ha. And now since we have done all these, okay, our next task is to basically send all these stocks which was scanned suppose at 9:15 a.m. To the Telegram group. Okay, so let's just clear all, let's just send all these stocks that was screened suppose at 9:15 a.m. to this chatting group. Okay, so just to save this to basically screen stocks. Okay, to a, okay, so screen stocks, so it will now basically open. And yeah, so we now have the screen stocks. Okay, screen stocks of what we want is the stock name stock, or no, we want the symbol. Okay, so symbol, so we can create this into list, convert this into list, and the screen stocks list. Okay, now the message, or basically the bot, or basically for stock in screen stock list. Okay, we can send all these stocks into the Python, into the Telegram group. Okay, basically the bot dot send message of the chat ID equal to group ID comma the text equal to, we can assign simply the date time. Okay, so we have not imported the date time, let's just import the date time. Okay, so date time dot date time dot now. Okay, since now we have got the date time dot now, basically the current time. Okay, at what the time the stocks were screened. Okay, we'll send the message here in the name of stocks screen, stock screen at, okay, we can use the F string and just post the time dot now, okay, at this is basically the stock. Okay, so let's just run this and we can now see stock screened at 2021 523. Okay, we have see, just check the time and check this here. Okay, we have got the HFCL, Bank of Baroda and all these stocks. Okay, that were all in our screened stocks data frame basically. Okay, the HFCL was the first one, the Bank of Baroda, SBIN, the IDFC First, the R Power, the Idea, PNB, Yes Bank, all are the same. Okay, so now since we have all got since we have got this basic thing, okay, what we can now do is we can just improve this a bit, okay, by okay, yeah, so we now have the first name in the name of stock name and then we have the time, okay, screened at this time. Okay, this is looking much better. So what we can do next is we can simply just sort this a little bit. First of all, just bring this up. These were the libraries that we needed. This is a URL, so URL you can choose your own, okay, and so we can initialize this at the start. So our next basically task is to get these stocks that were not already screened, okay. Suppose at 9:15, okay, we ran the screener, okay, and multiple 5, 6, 10 stocks were scanned, okay, and at 9:30, okay, and after 15 minutes as soon as we just ran the screener, okay, we don't want the stocks that were already screened, okay. So what we can do is simply delete all those, or basically get the slice, or basically create a list comprehension wherein we remove or we just subset the stocks that were not there in the first scan, okay. So what we can do now is we can save this screened stocks into a basically a CSV format, screened stocks dot to CSV. We can save this in the name of today's date, today dot CSV comma index equals to false. So this will basically save all the screened stocks into the directory, okay. So if we just do pd dot read CSV or basically today's screen stocks and today's date, okay, date time dot date dot today dot CSV, okay, so this is what we'll get, okay. So if we are having see, at the first time of the day, okay, if we are scanning for the first time of the day, we can simply do this, okay, we can simply scan this for the first time and just, okay, send these messages. But what if we are doing for the second time, okay, so if we are doing for the second time, what we can do is we can simply create so this is for the first time, hashtag for the first time of the day, okay, for the rest times of the day, for the rest day. So for the rest day, suppose we are so for the first time of the day, it was basically the 9:15 a.m. Okay, so now the time is 9:30 a.m. Okay, so for the rest time of the day. Okay, so first we need to check what all were the stocks that were not screened till now. Okay, I mean what all were the stocks that were screened till now. Okay, so earlier screened stocks, we can just create a basically the variable wherein we can just read this CSV, pd.read CSV, we'll get the all those stocks that were earlier screened today. Okay, this one. So we can create simply a list out of this. List is equals to earlier screened stocks of symbol. We can create a symbol list. Okay, symbol list earlier screened stocks list. Yeah, we are having the stocks that were already screened. Now what we have to do is we have to make a fresh scan. Okay, so now we have to again do screened stocks is equals to basically this part. Okay, or okay, so we will again scan for screened stocks at some time. Okay, if the file basically the CSV is already existing. Okay, if the CSV of today's date already exists. Okay, so what I mean by this is basically if we are having, okay, we just saved the if we scanned for the first time of the day, we simply saved the screened stocks underscore today's date. Okay, so what we did is we saved the stocks that were screened today in the screened stocks underscore today's date dot CSV format. Okay, so we'll check basically if the file already exists. Okay, for the rest of the day, suppose at 9:15 we didn't scan. Okay, and at 9:30 we are scanning again without scanning for the first day. Okay, so what we can do is we can simply check if the file is already existing in the directory. So for that we can do is simply import os. Okay, so if os dot path dot is file of f astria screen stocks date time dot date dot today dot csv, if this is already there, okay, then print exists. Okay, if this file exists, then only we'll do all this calculation. Okay, if not, or if it is for the first time of the day, we'll do this. Okay, so we can do that in else. Okay, yeah, so we'll later merge that. Okay, so earlier screened stocks list, we have this, the current we'll get. Okay, and okay, so since now the market is closed, we'll be getting the same screened stocks and the earlier screened today. So what we can do is we can simply add one two stocks of our own. Okay, suppose add lol. Okay, suppose whatever screen stocks list. Now we have the two other stocks. Okay, So now what we'll do is we'll basically create a list comprehension wherein we'll check if the stocks of the screened stocks list already exist in the first one. Okay, and we'll only take all those stocks out that were not there in the first one. Okay, so we'll just simply create a list comprehension wherein stock. So what will this list comprehension do? Okay, suppose let's just break this down. Okay, for stock in screened stocks list. Okay, so for stocks in screen stock list, if stock not in earlier screened stock list, okay, just print the stock. Okay, we have the lol and roll. Okay, this is a list comprehension version wherein we can just simply do this in one line and without basically appending or doing all those things. Okay, so if we do in this way, step by step way, then we can do is new screen stocks list, okay, equals to blank, and we can simply do is new screened stocks dot append of stock. Okay, so we now have the new stocks screen, okay, list. Okay, so yeah, we can remove this. Okay, so what we can do is simply now send all these new screened stocks to our Telegram. Okay, so for sending that, we can again use that for stock in. Okay, for stocks in, earlier we were doing for the first time, so we were having screened stocks list, now we're having the new screened stocks list. Okay, so if we just press this, we'll see the lol screened at 20 21 05 23 20 43 40. Let's just check this time instance. Okay, this is same almost. Okay, so we are now getting the new screened stocks. Okay, so let's just save this in a basically this all. This is part one. Okay, so guys, let's just go through this once again. Okay, so for the first time of the day, okay, suppose the market opened at 9:15 a.m. okay, and we were to basically screen the stocks for the first time. Okay, so what will this do is it will first basically check if the file in the name of today's date exists in the directory. Okay, if it exists, okay, then it means that the stocks were already screened today. Okay, and we are doing it for the second or other time. Okay, and if it is not found in the directory, then it means that we are scanning for the first time in the day. Okay, so if we are scanning for the first time in the day, what will this do? This will basically create screened stocks. It will basically get this function, okay, wherein it will just fetch the screen table. Okay, and it will save it to the CSV format, okay, which will be checked later throughout the day for if the stocks were already scanned or not. Okay, and so it will now send the messages to the Telegram group. Okay, so this basically. Okay, and now what we'll do is if other time, okay, now the first time it is scanned and the CSV is saved in the today's date format, suppose at 9:45 a.m. okay, it will again screen, okay, it will again check if today's date CSV is found in the directory or not. If it is found, then it will basically create the, it will basically fetch the earlier screened stocks today. Okay, earlier screened stocks it will fetch, and then it will again screen to check if new stocks were found or not. Okay, if they are found, it will basically send those new stocks, new screened stocks. It will first filter all those new screened stocks, and then basically it will send all those stocks to the Telegram group. Okay, now we are missing at one point, that we should save this basically the earlier screened stocks along with the screened stocks, okay, such that if we are scanning for the third time at that day, so we don't get the all those two screened okay stocks list. We'll basically concat the screened stocks and the earlier screened stocks list. Okay, we'll basically join those. Okay, so pt.concat earlier and screen stocks with access equal to 0, that is row wise. Okay, and we'll also delete the duplicates. We need to select a column by which we'll basically delete the all the symbols. Okay, I mean all the duplicate rows. So we can select symbol here and save this in the screen stocks, and now to CSV. Okay, so this format. Okay, so this should be done as soon as all the messages are sent. Okay, so now we have this screen stocks list. So now we have got the screener made. Okay, now the thing is, we want to schedule this in such a way that it screens at 9:15, it screens at 9:30, 9:45, whatever time we want. Okay, so we can first of all create this. There is a library in the name of schedule which we can use to schedule our basically the task. Okay, so for that we can simply do is first just create an R list. Suppose, okay, and what are the minutes we want to scan for? So all these are the hours and minutes we want to scan for. For H in hours, for M in minutes, or basically the for HOUR for R and minute, MINUTE. Okay, so we want to get all these basically the minutes. Okay, let's just check this. At what all these times were, will we scan? Okay, so let's just print the hour and the minute. Okay, now we have the 9. Okay, so we basically don't want the 9:0th instance. Okay, or we don't want the 9:15 instance, suppose. Okay, so we can basically do we can just first of all assign the value to this as just convert this into date time first of all. So schedule time equals to date time dot time of suppose at 9. Okay, suppose at hour and minute. Okay, and we can print the schedule time. So this is now converted into date and time format. Okay, but we want to limit the time from suppose 9:15 till 15:15 or 15:30, whatever. Okay, so what we can do is we can just simply use if schedule time is less than or greater than basically the date time dot time of 9:15. Okay, if this is okay, and if scheduled time is less than 15:15, or basically less than or equal to 15:15, okay, and greater than or equal to 9:15, okay, then only we want to scan, then we can print schedule time. So we have the our desired basically times at which we want to screen, okay. So now we can simply schedule the task, okay. So first of all, for scheduling the task, we need to convert this. We basically need this to do again and again. Okay, so we can convert this into a function, okay, named job. Okay, suppose job is basically the standard name for scheduling functions. Okay, so we can do that. Okay, so we will now basically use the schedule library, okay, to schedule this task. Okay, so schedule.every, we need to do this for every day. Okay, at what time? So at suppose a string of the schedule time. Okay, schedule time, or what we want to perform, that do job. Okay, we just accidentally placed the bracket. Okay, so if we can check the 9:15 every day, let's just remove this print first of all. Now let's check. Okay, so every one day at 9:15, okay, do job, and next run would be, okay, so it will basically do the job at 24th of May 2021, okay, at 9:15 a.m. okay, so this is scheduled. Okay, so we have just scheduled the tasks. Okay, now what we want to do is simply just do the perform these tasks. For that we need to just run the true loop. Okay, and we just need to schedule dot run pending. We need to just run the pending basically the all the pending task that was scheduled. Okay, so let's just sleep for something. Sleep we don't have actually. Just add the sleep library from time, import sleep. We'll sleep for every 300 seconds. So 300 seconds is basically the 5 minutes. Okay, so it will now sleep till tomorrow. Okay, until all this job is fulfilled or
scheduled. It's 21 hours.
So until all this task is basically done. Okay, performed. Now this is done manually for first day. Okay, or one day. Okay, we simply want to run this for the rest of the days. Okay, for the n number of days, suppose. Okay, until and unless we stop this manually. Okay, or we just stop. So what we can do is, we can simply, first of all, we need to check if the days we are running at is not Saturday or Sunday. Okay, so for that, first just let's just check if date time dot date dot today dot month, or basically the day, weekday basically. Okay, so weekday is not equal to 5 or 6. Okay, so 5 in terms of this system is basically the Saturday, and 6th is Sunday. Okay, so weekday should not be equal to, and should not be equal to 5. Okay, so since this is not true, it is basically showing false. Okay, so what we can do is, we can apply this to the main. Okay, we can simply, so let's just check if today's date time is not equal to 5 or 6. That is not equal to Saturday or Sunday. If not equal to Saturday, Sunday, then that means we are screening for Monday till Friday. Okay, we are not here accounting for the holidays. Okay, we can do that. Let's just go through the weekdays first. Okay, and if we are coming across any weekdays, weekends, so we can simply eliminate those days, and we can simply sleep for those days. So for that, we need to check the first of all to check if today is Saturday or Sunday. Since now today is Sunday, okay, we want it. We want this code to sleep till tomorrow morning. Okay, that is 9:15 a.m. So what we'll do is we'll simply check the first of all today's time. Now time we have now date time. We'll now basically make a time till the time we have to sleep. Okay, so we have to sleep for now dot date time, and this should be 24th of May 2021 till 9:15 a.m. Okay, so for that we need to first check the date time dot date dot day. Okay, I mean now date time dot day. Okay, that is 23. We need to sleep for the next day till we can 24. So we have to sleep for the till next day. Okay, so that is 24th of May. Okay, so let's just calculate the get the month and the year. Okay, so let's just combine this into one. There is one thing, date time dot date. Using that we can okay change this. So we were having till now today's date. Okay, we are now having the tomorrow's date. Okay, now what we want is tomorrow's time till 9:15 a.m. So we'll calculate the date time. We'll just simply make a date time till tomorrow time. Okay, so we are having this, and we'll combine this date time, date and time together. Okay, using the date time dot date time dot combine. Okay, so we now have the tomorrow's basically the time. Okay, tomorrow's 9:15 a.m. at 24th of May 2021. This is the tomorrow's time. So next date time. Okay, so next date time is this and this. Now date time is this. So let's just subtract the next date time. Okay, by subtracting this we will get the seconds to sleep basically. Okay, so we are now having the 43594. If this code just sleep for 543594 seconds, so it will wake tomorrow at 9:15 a.m. okay, to simply run the code. Okay, second. Okay, so we are having the 43594 seconds. We'll sleep for this number of seconds. So sleep and this. Okay, yeah, so let's just add this, combine these. So now if we want to run this continuously for say some x amount of time, we can simply convert this into the while true loop. Okay, while true, that is the loop till infinity, or till whenever we want to stop this, we can simply just open the code and stop it. Okay, so if I run this, it will simply wait till the since we are at Sunday. Okay, so today is Sunday. Okay, so it will wait till tomorrow. Okay, to run the next time, to run the screener. Okay, that's it. So now guys, we are done. Okay, and I'm very much thankful to you guys. I have just crossed around 322 subscribers mark. Okay, on the YouTube channel. And yeah, thank you guys for your love. and keep sharing. Do like, comment, share and subscribe. So guys, if you have any queries, you can ping me directly on YashRJ25 handle on Twitter, Telegram and Instagram. Okay, there might be a delay in answering back, but I'll definitely try to answer to each and every one of you. Maybe not today, but in one or two day time frame. Okay, and one more thing, for your demands, if you guys have any requests, okay, I'll urge you guys to just go on to the entirety. Suppose the channel is entirety, the group is basically the entirety tech discussions. Okay, just post a request with the hashtag. Okay, so just write down. So in the upcoming video, I'll help you guys to use to basically set up this chatting code on the AWS platform, okay, wherein you can automate this whole process. You won't have to linger a bit in this process. Basically, it will automatically start at the morning, okay, at the 9:15 a.m. It will screen till your desired time and it will automatically shut that down, and in the process it will send you these stocks that you have actually selected the screener for. Okay, so yeah, that's it guys, and do comment, share, like, subscribe.